Today we're going to look at hypergraphs, which are a generalization of graphs. Intuitively, a hypergraph is what we get when we allow our edges to join more than two vertices at a time. More formally, we can define a hypergraph to be a pair of a vertex set, V, and a family of subsets of V, which we call E, where the members of E are our edges. If you compare this to the definition of a simple graph, the only two differences are that for a graph, E is a set of distinct pairs of vertices, while in a hypergraph, E is a family of subsets of vertices of any size. That is, it allows for the same subset to appear more than once, and the subsets don't just have to be pairs. When we visualize a hypergraph, the vertices are depicted the same as in graphs, except an edge in a hypergraph is a closed curve that encloses the vertices incident to that edge. For example, if we had this hypergraph, here's one way we could visualize it. Just like in graph theory, the order of a hypergraph is the number of vertices, and the size of a hypergraph is the number of edges. In this example, the order is 5 and the size is 3. Let's cover a little more hypergraph terminology. Like in graph theory, the edges that include a vertex V are said to be incident to V. The statement, vertex V is incident to edge E, means that V is a member of E, and the statement edge E is incident to vertex V means the same thing. The symmetry of incidence will be useful later when we talk about dual hypergraphs. The set of all edges incident to a vertex V is written as E of V. In the hypergraph shown here, what edges are incident to vertex D? They are E sub 2 and E sub 3, as those edges contain vertex D. Also, what vertices are incident to edge E sub 3? They are C, D, and E, the vertices that E sub 3 contains. Moving on, we can define empty edges to be edges that are incident with zero vertices. They are empty sets. We can also define isolated vertices. They are the vertices that are incident with zero edges. In this hypergraph, edge E sub 3 is empty, and vertex V sub 2 is isolated. Singletons are what we call edges that are incident with exactly one vertex, such as E sub 4 in this hypergraph. And pendant vertices are vertices that are incident with exactly one edge, such as V sub 4 and V sub 1. Returning to our terminology page, let's add these new terms. Now back to our example, we can define two more terms relating to edges: included edges and multiple edges. Included edges, such as E sub 4 in this example, are those that are a subset of another edge in the hypergraph, in this case E sub 2. Multiple edges are duplicate edges. This is when we have two distinct edges that cover the same set of vertices. In this hypergraph, there are no multiple edges. But suppose we added this edge, E sub 5. It contains the same set of vertices as E sub 1, meaning E sub 1 and E sub 5 would be multiple edges. Note that all multiple edges are included edges. And for hypergraphs with more than one edge, empty edges are also included edges. We can now add these two terms to our terminology page. Finally, we can define simple hypergraphs to be those that do not contain included edges, meaning they don't contain empty edges or multiple edges either. Interestingly, we can define simple hypergraphs with a pair of a vertex set and an edge set, just like an ordinary graph, as we would not have repeated edges. Moving on, let's look at the degree of a vertex in a hypergraph. We define the degree of a vertex to be the number of edges that are incident to it. Next, for adjacency, Just like in graph theory, two vertices are said to be adjacent if there exists an edge that they are both incident to. Notice, however, that the number of vertices adjacent to a vertex V is not necessarily the same as the degree of V. As an example of this, in this hypergraph, vertex V sub 4 has degree 2, as two edges contain it. However, it's adjacent to 5 vertices, V sub 1, V sub 2, V sub 3, V sub 5, and V sub 6. So remember, degree is the number of edges incident to a vertex, which is not necessarily equal to the number of vertices adjacent to a vertex. Next, let's define degree and adjacency for edges. The degree of an edge is the number of vertices incident to that edge. It's the edge's size. The edge E sub 1 in this example has degree 3 because it contains 3 vertices. Two edges are said to be adjacent if they have at least one vertex in common, or more formally, if their intersection is non-empty. In this case, E sub 1 is adjacent to E sub 2 because they share vertex V sub 4. Now let's do an exercise. Can you find the degrees of all edges and vertices in this hypergraph? Vertex V sub 1 has degree 1, as it's incident to exactly one edge. The same goes for vertex V sub 2. Vertex V sub 3 is incident to two edges, E sub 1 and E sub 2, so it has degree 2. The same goes for vertex V sub 4. Vertex V sub 5 is incident to one edge, E sub 3, so it has degree 1. Vertex V sub 6 is incident to one edge, E sub 2, so it has degree 1. Finally, vertex V sub 7 is incident to 0 edges, so it has degree 0. Now for the edge degrees. E sub 1 is incident to 4 vertices, so it has degree 4. E sub 2 is incident to 3 vertices, so it has degree 3. E sub 3 is incident to 1 vertex, so it has degree 1. And finally, E sub 4 is incident to 0 vertices, so it has degree 0. Moving on, just like in graph theory, where a regular graph is one whose vertices all have the same degree, a K-regular hypergraph is a hypergraph whose vertices all have degree K. That means they're all incident to K edges. Also, K-uniform hypergraphs are hypergraphs whose edges all have degree K. That means they each contain K vertices. The hypergraph shown here is 2 regular and 3 uniform. Every edge is incident to exactly 3 vertices, and every vertex is incident to exactly 2 edges. As the second to last concept in this video, just like we have subgraphs in graph theory, in hypergraph theory we have subhypergraphs. A hypergraph H prime is said to be a subhypergraph of a hypergraph H if its vertex set is a subset of the vertex set of H, and if every edge in its edge family is also in the edge family of H. A partial subhypergraph is a special type of subhypergraph, where the vertex set equals the vertex set of the original graph. You can think of partial subhypergraphs as a generalization of the notion of spanning subgraphs in graph theory. Another special type of subhypergraph is an induced subhypergraph, which generalizes the notion of vertex-induced subgraphs in graph theory. Essentially, we choose to keep a subset, V prime, of the original vertex set V, and we keep only the edges that are entirely between vertices in V prime. We do not leave out any edges that were entirely between vertices we chose to keep in our graph. If we have the following hypergraph, the hypergraph with the same vertex set as the original, but with only edges E sub 1 and E sub 2, is a partial subhypergraph, and that it leaves out no vertices, but contains only some of the original edges. Additionally, the subhypergraph induced by vertices A and B would be this. It's a hypergraph with no edges and two vertices. Finally, this subhypergraph is not an induced subhypergraph nor a partial subhypergraph. It's just a subhypergraph. We've left out edge E1, even though it's entirely between vertices in our vertex set, and we've left out vertex C as well. But every vertex and edge in our hypergraph is in the original, so it's still a subhypergraph. Before we cover our final and very important concept of dual hypergraphs, let's compare some of the terminology we defined for edges and vertices. The degree of a vertex is the number of edges incident to that vertex. The degree of an edge is the number of vertices incident to that edge. A K-regular hypergraph is one where all vertices are incident to K edges. And an R-uniform hypergraph is one where all edges are incident to R vertices. Two vertices are said to be adjacent if there is some edge that they are both members of. Two edges are said to be adjacent if there's a vertex that they are both incident to. Vertices with degree 0 are called isolated vertices, and edges with degree 0 are called empty edges. Vertices with degree 1 are called pendant vertices, and edges with degree 1 are called singletons. Now that we've compared some of the terminology for vertices and edges, what do you think would happen if we took a hypergraph H and built a new hypergraph H star, whose vertices are the edges in H, and whose edge family X is defined as follows. X is the family of sets X1, X2, and so on, up to X(n), where X(i) is defined to be the set of all members of E that contain vertex V(i) in hypergraph H. In other words, our operation converts an edge E in the original hypergraph into a vertex E in H star, and converts a vertex V(i) in the original hypergraph into an edge X(i) that is incident to all the vertices in H star that correspond to edges that were incident to vertex V(i) in the original hypergraph. Note that an edge X(i) is incident to a vertex E(k) in H star if and only if vertex V(i) and edge E(k) are incident in H. The hypergraph H star is called the dual hypergraph of H. From the definition of the dual of H, we can see that the dual of K-regular hypergraphs are K-uniform. The dual of R-uniform hypergraphs are R-regular. Isolated vertices become empty edges. Empty edges become isolated vertices. Pendant vertices become singleton edges, and singleton edges become pendant vertices. The degree of a vertex in the original hypergraph is the degree of the corresponding edge in the dual hypergraph. The degree of an edge in the original hypergraph is the degree of its corresponding vertex in the dual hypergraph. And interestingly, adjacency is maintained. A pair of adjacent vertices becomes a pair of adjacent edges, and a pair of adjacent edges becomes a pair of adjacent vertices. Let's do an example now. What's the dual of this hypergraph? First, create the vertex set. Then, go through the list of vertices in our original hypergraph, and for each one, produce its corresponding edge that will be incident to the vertices in the dual that represented edges incident to our vertex in the original. Starting with vertex V(1), which was incident to edges E(1) and E(2), we will create edge X(1), which will be incident to vertices E(1) and E(2). Moving on to vertex V(2), V(2) was incident to edges E(1), E(2), and E(3). So we'll create edge X(2), which will be incident to vertices E(1), E(2), and E(3). Next, vertex V(3) is incident to edge E(2). So edge X(3) will be incident to vertex E(2). Next, vertex V(4) is incident to edges E(1) and E(3). So edge X(4) will be incident to vertices E(1) and E(3). Finally, vertex V(5) is incident to edge E(3). So edge X(5) will be incident to vertex E(3). This is our result. If you notice, dependent vertices became singleton edges. Additionally, our hypergraph was 3 uniform, as all edges contain 3 vertices, but our dual is 3 regular. All vertices in the dual are incident to 3 edges. That's it for this video. In my next video, we're going to take a deeper look at hypergraphs. Specifically, we're going to cover matrix representations of hypergraphs, as well as simple graph representations of hypergraphs. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe. Have a great day.